Hi, and welcome to September's editorial video. This month, we're discussing the very important topic of hotels' websites and direct distribution. Joining me in this video will be Hicham Benyebdri from Userguest and Fausto Marques from GuestCentric, both with a variety of knowledge and experience that's related to this particular topic. If you haven't already, make sure that you also look at the articles that we've written or that have been written for this editorial. Again, we've got more than one and each offers a different perspective as well as information. And we also have a great lineup for the podcast for you to listen to the next time you're in the car on a long drive or perhaps walking the dog. And yes, as usual, the infographic is available for our premium subscribers and our members and their customers. The hotel's website is a critical element of their business, not just because it supports a hotel's direct distribution strategy, but also because it really is the main representation to all the newcomers and the return guests for the hotel. It's the first time a potential new guest will be presented with the brand and how it is represented. Also, how they experience it and their potential journey as they begin the booking process. Because of this, there are a number of factors that go into a successful hotel website for today, as well as the booking engine, especially the design and the layout. It should be easy to use, effectively communicate the hotel's brand message with visuals that are appealing to the eye, both photos and video. Of course, the ease of booking that offers what the booker is looking for and nothing else is also very, very important. Let's go to our guests and see what they think about this.
Aside from a technical perspective, so that you can name a few loading times, that having the right pictures, having the right buttons in the right places, the book now button and the call to action, making sure that everything works from a technical perspective, looking for dates, check in, check out dates, this and that. So aside from that, I think the most important bit is having a seamless booking experience or user experience in this case. It's to make it as easy as possible for the user to, okay, I need to start the process. I need to start purchasing. How can you make it as easy as possible for them to just jump there quickly, start looking at rooms, start looking at prices, start looking at availability, and go from there. I think it's understated a bit within the industry that we're not really focusing so much on let's send that visitor to the shop basically and start buying. So aside from those factors, having the technical part and having just an easy experience, one key factor I think is providing incentives, providing some kind of offers, discounts, extra benefits, basically highlighting the fact that booking on the direct website is better. That's the only thing that I think would really convince users to think from the get-go, as soon as they land on the website, thinking, okay, well, I can get a good deal here. One thing that we need to keep in mind is the user, the visitor coming to your website, unless they're a return guest, but there's high chances that they've come from a booking.com or from Expedia previously. And once they land on your website, that's your chance to convince them that this is the right place to be. This is the right place to get the best price, to get the offer, to get the benefit, to get something exclusive. So I think the offering part, the discount, the incentive is extremely important just to convince them to, okay, let's start the process. Let's get to the shop and start buying directly from the website. So, yeah. So that's a bit our view. There's other factors, obviously, that we can talk a bit more. But also, I think having availability, pushing people to the right dates, having access to availability, and knowing what the hotel is looking to sell, that's also a big factor. But purely from a visitor perspective, it's really about providing that incentive and convincing them that they won't get a better deal than the direct website. From a automation perspective, I think one of the main elements is, again, if we talk mostly about the offering, so the discount, the incentives, is being able to, you need automation to be able to provide the right discount to the right user, depending on where they're coming from, depending on their geos. Expedia, Booking do this a lot, so what we call the geo pricing, geo fencing. There's a couple of different terms for this, but being able to target different type of users and providing them with a different type of incentive or offer based on their booking behavior. All these actions need the high level of automation. So automation, I think it's the key here, is being able to gather a lot of the data from the website, from other sources, whether it's from the PMS, whether it's from the revenue management system. Automation is very key to gather the right data and being able to do the right thing to cater to the user once they land on the website. That's also something that CRMs are doing. So you need that a high level of connectivity between different systems, and automation is the key there. So aside from that trend, I think automation being a big thing, the level of personalization is very important. We are being used to quite a bit of personalization in everything else. So whether it's Netflix, you're watching Netflix proposing different type of shows for you to watch, or Amazon, when you buy something, you're looking at a specific item, you're pushed other items. We're used to this while we shop online. So I think the industry is getting there. The hotel industry, we're definitely getting closer and closer to this and looking at things from a much more e-commerce perspective. So I think having hyper-personalization type of experience, booking experience, is key. And understanding really your users, understanding their booking behavior and the search behavior, based on that, those elements, being able to push the right offers, the right incentive, pushing the right package, and making sure that it fits with what they're looking for on one side, but it also fits with what the hotel is trying to achieve. What's their current challenges, whether it's occupancy challenges, whether it's ADR challenges. So having more systems connected together, having a high level of automation, allows you to hyper-personalize the booking experience and making sure that you can convince that user right away once they land on your website, having enough information and data to be able to really convince them and guarantee high success once they move to the next step and hopefully confirm and complete the booking. So I would say mainly those two trends, I think, or what I see pushing the boundaries a bit more, it's automation and that a high level of personalization, and it comes definitely from the fact that we are working more, the industry as a whole is working towards connecting more software together, having centralized the data a bit more, and have your systems work together to provide the best possible booking experience.
So I see hotel websites as a powerful tool for hotels to tell their guests how much the hotel cares about them and about their experience. Now, branding and images are the cornerstones of how hotels communicate with their guests and inspire them to book, along with revenue, packages, or offers. So the million-dollar question is, does your website reach your guests? And if we look at the direct booking process, we know that online searchers use OTAs to browse and price shop to different accommodation options. There is a research made by Full and Flip showing that 87% will generally visit the hotel website before booking hotel stay. So if you compare booking.com listing with a hotel website, there is no doubt that the hotel website better portrays both the personality of the property and the experience that the destination has to offer. Now, there might be a question about how the website can stand out. And over the past 9 years or so, I have been working exclusively with hotels. And one of the things that I've learned was that processing reservations was never been enough. So hotels must hunt for direct bookings, hunt for them. And I think the goal is clear. We should attract guests and force them to book direct. And to do so, we need to stimulate direct reservations through the complete guest journey. So attention, interest, desire, and action. And those should be the steps to monitor. So first of all, hotels should try to redirect traffic from OTAs to their website. And there are a bunch of cool features available for them to do this. The automatic SEO for searches on the hotel name, the connection with Google free booking links, or even the brand level meta. Now we know that the selling process starts on the website. So there is a pack of direct boosting technology that can lift direct bookings. An easy to use default menu with top visited pages, activation message to create urgency, but also the trust at different stages of the direct booking process. Tools that have that allow websites to have the prices, optimize the mobile version, have CTA's functionality embedded with the website design, or even URL generators. We name it click to book, which is really to extend the power of the booking engine across social media, and this allows hotels to send links with pre-selected offers, dates, or occupation. But still, the guest journey is not complete, so we should close the process, so finish the funnel with a reservation number. And I think it's really important to scan and to check your booking engine and verify if an easy and fast checkout process is implemented. You might want to check if you have a guest recognition system for returning guests. Do you have a special rate for them? Or even check if all critical terms to finish the booking are easy to verify and to complete. And an additional note may be linked to this vision of hunting for reservations. I believe that websites should never say no to someone who's searching. So personally, I recommend for this three features: the availability calendar, so you can see in one place which dates are available in a very fast way. The flexible date search, let's say that you search for a date that you don't have availability, you can see immediately a suggestion by the website and by the booking engine of the next available date. And for hotels that belong to hotel groups, and the possibility to have a tool that suggests other hotel of the chain. It's really, really relevant for that. So to conclude, I think we should never overlook the booking process, even though it's crucial to have a website design that allows visitors to visually experience your hotel before booking a stay. It will all be for nothing if the booking process is not optimized. Some years ago, someone called Peter Drucker said, "You can't manage what you can't measure." So I believe hotel managers, they need to have a strong analytical skills and tools that allow them to make quick decisions. Incomplete or inaccurate data ultimately results in missed opportunities and money down the drain. So more than ever, I think optimization strategy should be always supported by data. Now, to answer your question, we spot a tendency from hotels to optimize four different areas: security, automation, visibility, and user experience. Security, because I think guests are growing more aware of the danger of their private data being intercepted online. So poorly secured websites will continue to underperform. Also, online business and internet transactions over the recent years has exploded. So hotels need to be more aware than ever and keeping their own and customers' data safe. And then I think due to the accelerated growth of electronic payments and the increase of online card frauds, the European Commission released the Payment Service Directive 2, so the PSD2. And so I think having an accurate GDPR and cookie policy, SSL, payment gateway solutions are some of the stuff that hotels are spending more energy trying to optimize. Then we have the user experience part. So I think the ultimate goal is always to make it easy for guests to book direct. So a speedy reservation process and easy navigation and responsiveness are what our hotels are running after. I think the web vitals play a huge role on this matter, since they guide hoteliers to work and understand which areas need to be improved. CTAs, pop-ups, and mobile optimization are always the most wanted in this terms of optimization. And then the automation. The automation, I think, due to the social and travel conditions caused by COVID-19, guests value more efficient interaction with hotels. And I think hotels must respond to this demand. Also, given the current labor and cost constraints, we expect a widespread adaptation of AI technology, including virtual assistants, chatbots, big data, or machine learning from hotels. I think hotels will want to ensure that they have a software that enables employees to deliver better and more efficient service at a fraction of the time and cost of the business. And then visibility, which is the ultimate goal, is to create brand awareness and generating leads throughout optimization. So meta search, search engine optimization, so SEO, and social media. To conclude, I think currently there is a huge range of tools and functionality that help optimizing the online performance of hotels. However, resources and time are limited. And I believe a hotel should support their optimization strategy in data and monitor very closely the current demands of the travel industry.
Well, that's it for September's video, folks. I hope you found this information helpful and that it offers an opportunity to review perhaps your own website and direct distribution strategy. There are various factors involved, so don't feel that it's all too much to wrap your head around. Seek assistance if need be. Ask your vendors to help and talk to your colleagues and, of course, talk to your guests. Find out what's important to them. Until next time, it's bye for now.